space, time, life itself. The secrets of the cosmos lie through the wormhole.
The quest for scientific knowledge has taken us on a breathtaking journey of discovery. We've unraveled the physics that govern the heavens and the tiny atoms that form our bodies. But science has not yet found proof that God created all this. Now there's a new place to look for an answer, because recent research suggests the truth may not be out there, but in here, inside all of us. Did God invent humanity? Or did we invent God? If religion is wired into the human brain, will it always be around? David Sloan Wilson, an anthropologist at Binghamton University in New York State, is a card-carrying evolutionist. He believes life on Earth evolved from a common ancestor, and he believes the future of God might be determined by one of evolution's greatest mysteries. A mystery that can be witnessed every holiday season.
These people are expressing a kind of a neighborliness through their decorations. Cooperation is a fundamental evolutionary puzzle. Why do we cooperate with others when that often involves helping them at the expense of ourselves?
David set out to find out why we cooperate with one another and how this social behavior spreads across communities.
We relied upon an old method in social psychology called the lost letter method. And what that involves is dropping stamped addressed envelopes on the sidewalks to see who is kind enough to pick up the envelope and take it to the mailbox.
David compiled the data to create this, a topographical chart of pro-social behavior. In other words, a map of how nice people are to one another in various neighborhoods.
Well, when we mapped Binghamton, we found this rugged terrain, basically. It looked like the Himalayas. The downtown area right there, that's like Death Valley, so that's a very unpro-social place.
According to his maps, once pro-social behavior gets strong enough in any one area, it tends to spread.
One of the things we're trying to accomplish is to empower neighborhoods to perceive themselves more as groups. And one way to do that is with a common project, such as building your own park in your neighborhood or painting an intersection.
David had expected he might find a connection between active churches and pro-social areas. But in Binghamton, he did not. He suspects that although religion promotes altruism, it is not our primary instigator of good behavior.
So in Europe, and especially Scandinavia, we see the spectacle of cathedrals much bigger than this one, which stand empty. And that's because Europe has become so much more existentially secure in the centuries since those cathedrals were built. So in a sense, if we could make the world a secure place, paradoxically, religion would attenuate. I would like to think that in a safe and secure world, we would still be a highly spiritual people. And the particular religious form that takes is something that we'll just have to witness.